my buddy Freddie Smith from Days of Our Lives, and he and I both had Bell's palsy, and you said you had it too. I saw last night. So like, tell me your experience, a little bit of experience about your experience with that. So, I mean, that's why I mentioned, like, I had it too. My father had it. My mother, like, what was it for you?
Yeah, it's crazy. I saw that like last night and commented to you about it. But dude, I got Bell's palsy. I've had a problem with like just like going nonstop. Like, and I still have issues with that, but since my Bell's palsy, I've definitely like learned the virtues of patience and like mental health and like just giving yourself time and space and everything. But yeah, I graduated school in December. I immediately went to New Zealand for 3 weeks, backpacked around New Zealand. I immediately went to Europe after that, and I backpacked around Europe for 2 months with a travel partner, shout out Rachel. And then I immediately moved to LA, and then the next day, for moving back to LA, I started a new job. And like, so I just like loaded myself on with like so much change and so much stress, and did not give myself, literally, I didn't give myself 24 hours of just like decompression for like 3.5-4 months. Cause even when I was starting my job and my mom came to visit me, and it was just like a lot, like 4 months straight total of like not resting once. And then like I had planned this Vegas trip for my friend at the time for his birthday at the end of like my second month in LA. And I was like, my first month in LA, I was like, that's when I'm going to decompress. Like, we're going to make it there. And then we're going to party. And just like after that, we're going to, you know, settle in and everything. Driving down to Vegas, my face starts to feel weird. And I'm like, I don't know what's going on. Like, my face is feeling weird. And my friend's like, oh, like, you know, don't worry about it. Let's just party and figure it out tomorrow. So the next day I woke up with half a paralyzed face.
Which side?
I thought I had a stroke.
Yeah, which side? Which side?
Left.
Like mine, left side, yep.
Yeah, I literally woke up, went to like the mirror. We've been up all night, of course, partying. And I just like looked at the mirror and I was like, okay, like I can't move half my face. Like something's wrong. And then just like, you know, went to the emergency room and they gave me some facial steroids and found out I had Bell's palsy. And then that was I'm sure you've been through it too. That was a hell of a 6 to 8 weeks recovery, like not fun. I was like hermited in my room and still meeting all these people from the new city I moved to. I had to wear like an eye patch at certain points.
Yeah, all right, yes.
But I have a cool story to how I got out of it, if you want to hear it.
We want to hear it, of course, please. Let's want to hear it.
True story, and then, you know, take this how you will, but I, 6 weeks in, I'm in the backyard with my roommates. We're just trying to have a lazy Sunday. I had this chocolate bar edible that I hadn't eaten yet, and I was like, let's eat a little edible and just relax today. Ate this edible, you know, I started feeling it, and I went to the bathroom. I was like, I'm gonna try something, and I'm in the bathroom by myself. I'm like pretty high, and I like look in the bathroom mirror and like look at myself, and I'm like, I'm gonna go, like, I'm just gonna see what happens. And I literally, like, this is what I did in my brain. I jumped into my own head and like traversed through my nerve canals. I like, have you ever seen the Spider-Man movie? It's the opening.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
I was like jumping through nerve, because you know, Bell's palsy, like it's like the seventh nerve in your back of your head gets disconnected or something. I literally like in my head traversed these nerve canals, like found where this nerve was disconnected, like visually in my head, like, and like zapped it like a bunch of times and like till it connected again. And then I like came out and my lip twitched on the left side. My lip twitched. 6 weeks of not moving at all, and my lip twitched. And I like ran outside to my roommates. I was like, guys, look at this. Is this in my head or what's happening? And I twitched my lip and everyone cheered. And then like 2 weeks later, like it was just from there on like a gradual healing process. Like 2 weeks later, I was like 85% back to normal. And then like, you know, it took a little bit of time after that to get 100%. But that was just, it's just a cool example of like, you know, the power of the mind and the body. Like obviously who knows what really happened, but like placebo effect or not, like something happened there and I actually was able to move my mouth.
No, I'm gonna tell you, no, I was gonna say that's the power of the mind. And I think for some of us who went through a lot longer than you did, actually, I had a more very severe, you saw my face, it was like totally, looked like a pirate, it's like totally one side, like, you know, kind of weird.
Yeah.
And for me, because I had nothing, I couldn't do anything else, I did a lot of research. So I started eating certain vitamins for inflammation, I started not eating certain things, I did rest. Because that was like, that was a big thing. So you need to rest. That whole, your brain has gone, like you said, I was doing 8 million things. And I feel like I started getting better because I started really thinking, I'm going to get better now. We're going to do this. We got to think positive. I can't just add more negative stuff into my brain where that's where the stuff's happening, is in your brain.
Yeah.
kind of like me, it kind of connected somehow. Yeah. I like to be a good edible every once in a while. I didn't do that when I was doing that time, but I had certain teas I drank. I mean, your whole point is just that you're trying to connect with yourself.
Yeah.
That's how you started to get better.
That the mind and body connection is so powerful.
I agree with that. I really do agree with that. So, I mean, it's just, but yeah, you know how it is, the isolation, the just kind of that you can't really do much.
Yeah.
Hard to eat, it's hard to chew, yeah. It's hard to talk. I mean, it's like, it's the strangest thing.
Yeah, I used to eat lunch in like my bathroom stall because I couldn't keep anything in my fucking mouth.
It's so weird. And also, the weird thing is how it comes on, because like for me, the same thing. I woke up going, I couldn't spit.
Yeah.
I was trying to brush my teeth and things are just drooling. It was just drooling out. I'm like,
something's hurt. Right.
Right. And it doesn't even hurt at first. Like, it doesn't even hurt. It's just kind of like, my face is paralyzed. And I just watched it just literally go down. But it was my left side also. But if we said we think it's because of stress, literally because you're just doing too much. Your brain says, done. Like, we're gonna stop you, give you a timeout.
Yeah.
Seriously, that's what it felt like. It felt like my brain was telling me, don't do that again.
Yeah. So I'm glad you're better.